Good morning, class 10 student. This is a worksheet video for class 10 chapter radioactivity, which is a part of unit 2 syllabus. So let's begin with the worksheet. See, here in the first part of the worksheet, it is given SAQ and LAQ, mixed question, and then the next part is MCQ. MCQ's answer will be given in that answer sheet along, and the solution I will show you in the board. And SAQ, LAQ, few answers given in the PDF, and others you need to copy from here. So let's begin with that. First one, what is isotope? Give example. What is isotope? Give example. As we know, whenever we are dealing with that nuclear physics, we are very fond of isotopes. Isotopes means the atoms, there are few atoms which have the same element, who are belongs to same element, they are having same atomic number but different mass number. Same atomic number but different mass number. So the atoms have same atomic number but different mass number. Atomic number same means same type of proton they are having, and mass number different means different neutrons they are having. So they are called the isotope of one another. As per example, protium, deuterium and tritium, both are having atomic number 1 but they are having different mass number, means they are having different neutron. So this is protium, deuterium and tritium. Clear? So they are the isotope of one another. Normally in radioactive phenomena it is seen that the elements which have the same name but same atomic number but due to the variation of their mass number, one can take part in the radioactive reaction, others not. So isotope means same atomic number but different mass number. They are called isotope of one another. Going for the next question, question number 2. What is the difference between stable isotope and radioactive isotope? Difference between stable isotope and radioactive isotope. There are few isotopes which have number of neutrons more than the number of protons. They are called the radioactive isotope. And stable isotope have which have nearly equal to neutron proton, means same number of neutrons and nearly equal to same number of proton, means so those who are having large number of neutron compared to their proton, they will show the radioactivity decay or radioactivity phenomena, means this can emit alpha, beta, gamma ray. And those have nearly equal to, nearly equal to that neutron proton, so they are called the stable isotope, means normally they can part in they are taking part in chemical reaction but not taking part in radioactive decay. Means uranium 235-92, this is one, and another one, uranium 238-92. So I am having two things. So these two are the radioactive isotope. Example means both of these isotopes of uranium can take part in radioactive decay. Whereas the stable isotope who does not show radioactive decay, who has same number of, nearly equal to same number of neutron proton ratio, showing carbon. Carbon has 3 isotopes. One of them means 12, 6, 13, C6. These two will not take part in radioactive decay, but these will take part in radioactive decay. So the isotopes of an atom which have nearly equal to same number of neutron proton, they will not take part in radioactive decay, so they are the stable isotope. And those who are having huge number of neutron with respect to the proton, they will take part in radioactive decay, so they are called radioactive isotope. Coming for the next question, that is number 3, what is isobar? See, in this chapter we will go through that few things, isotope, isobar, isotone. So here question is isobar. Isobar means, just like isotope, isobar means the atoms which have same number of mass, means mass number same but different atomic number, mass number same but different atomic number, they are called isobar of one another. Isobar of one another. What is the mass number of sodium? Sodium we know, that is 23 11, and magnesium has how much? Magnesium has mass number is magnesium has mass number 23, but proton number or atomic number 12. So magnesium has mass number 23 but proton number is 12. So you can see here both the cases atomic number different but they are having same mass number, so they are called the isobar of one another. Clear? Now there are next question. Now going for the number 4 question, that is, what is mirror isobar? Mirror isobar is very simple. Mirror isobar, mirror means what? If I stand in front of the mirror, I will see, I can see my own image. So there are few atoms which has alternate neutron proton, means one's proton is neutron numbers of another, another proton is neutron number of this one, means they will be the mirror of one another. So that is called mirror isobar. Definition wise, if I want to say, that is, if number of protons and number of neutrons get interchanged, not literally interchanged, means mathematically we can see that they has interchanged with each other, interchange in the nucleus, they are called mirror isobar. So if I go through the same example here, what is the number of neutron? 23 minus 12, that is the number of neutrons, that will be equal to 11. And what is here number of neutrons? Here number of neutrons is 23 minus 11, that is 12. So its atomic number is the neutron number here, and he will say sodium's atomic number is the neutron number of here. So they has interchanged mathematically. In nature it is seen that. So they these two isobars will call the mirror isobar of one another. These two isobar will call the mirror isobar of one another. Radioactivity is a very easy chapter. Just mathematically think and few knowledge you need to do. Other things are very easy. Next one, next question is number 5. Who has discovered the phenomena of radioactivity? Obviously, Henry Becquerel discovered the phenomena of radioactivity. Coming to the next question, number 6. That is, radioactivity is a nuclear phenomena. Why? Explain. See, we know radioactivity is a nuclear phenomena, but why? Because most of the cases, maximum radioactivity is all about neutron-proton ratio. Means, suppose I am having an atom. Atoms mass number and proton number I know. That is, suppose I am having a atom. So this is its mass number, this is its atomic number. So what will be the number of proton? P equal to Z, exactly equal to same. And number of neutron will be A minus Z. Number of neutron will be A minus Z. Nothing problem is there. So if most of the cases, again telling, most of the cases, when you will study the same radioactivity chapter in class 12 or class 12, you can see there are some exceptions also. So right now, just I am letting you know, if neutron by proton ratio is greater than 1.5, if neutron, if for an atom, if neutron by proton ratio is greater than 1.5, that atom will show the neutron radioactivity phenomena. Now, whenever there is a radioactivity phenomena is occurring, we can see if I am changing physical property. Suppose pressure, temperature, that will not affect the radioactivity of the substance. That will not affect the radioactivity of the substance. But and also, if the ion changing some chemical property, suppose taking part in oxidation reduction, that does not change that the emission or the radioactivity is raised. So means what? The outermost electrons, outermost electron of the atom does not take part in the radioactivity. And the bottom line, the outermost electron does not take part in radioactivity. Who is taking part in the radioactivity? The proton, neutron which present in the atom. Proton or neutron present in the atom, where protons and neutrons belongs to? In the nucleus. So radioactivity is completely a nuclear phenomena. Answer given in the PDF, still I am explaining. So radioactivity is a completely nuclear phenomena. In books also this answer given. Okay, now coming for the next one. Number 7. Define alpha emission with nuclear equation. Means I need to define alpha emission with respect to equation. Suppose I am having a unstable nuclei. What I say? Unstable nuclei and radioactive nuclei both are same. So if neutron by proton ratio is more than 1.5, that will emit alpha, beta or gamma ray, or that will taking part any kind of radioactive decay. So if a number of if in a nucleus there is more number of neutron with respect to proton, means neutron by proton ratio is greater than 1.5, it may emit beta particle, it may emit alpha particle. Since question is belongs about alpha particle, so I am saying that it may emit a particle containing two protons and two neutrons. Means whatever may be the particle will emit, alpha particle, that having mass number 2 plus 2 equal to 4 and atomic number only 2. Clear? This kind of particle when emit, okay, first of all that particle obviously should bound to the nucleus, otherwise how could it emit? So if they containing 2 protons and 2 neutrons which bound tightly with the neutrons, then that particle is called alpha ray. Means whenever, suppose this is the parent nuclei, who is parent nuclei, who from whom the radiation occurs. So this is parent nuclei, from parent nuclei alpha particle emits. So if alpha particle emits, so new nucleus, suppose this is Y, whose mass number will be decreased by 4 and atomic number will decrease by 2, whose mass number will be decreased by 4 and atomic number will be decreased by 2, remember. And so and one alpha particle is emitting. Alpha particle generally written as in terms of helium. Alpha particle generally written as in terms of helium. So whenever alpha particle emission, I am saying that will be the definition, and this equation must you have to give, otherwise you will get a big zero. Achha, coming for next one. Uses of radio, what are the uses of radioactive isotope? See, in book, concise physics books, there are too many uses given. Okay, saying what are the uses? What you will read? Medical uses, scientific uses, industrial uses. So these three uses are very important. All the three uses you need to learn. Within that, any two uses you will give. So in a better suggest page number 292, nothing new in that. You just go through that books. So you will get the things what you need to give regarding that radioactive uses of radioactive isotope. So page number 292 is enough for radioactive isotope. Next one, concise physics written there. Concise physics page number 292. Next one, see. question number 9, it is given there few equation given. That equation I need to solve. Solve means there are some blank portion given. Then in that blank portion, what will be the answer? So let's go for that. First, number 9, what is given? It is given x unknown az, from there beta particle emits. Clear? So I am getting x1, then who is emitting? Then gamma emits. Clear? Then I am getting x2, then alpha emits. So I am getting x3, then again beta emits, I am getting x4. What I have to do? I have to write what will be in place of x1, what will be in place of x2, x3 and x4, so on. So first of all, as you had already studied radioactive decay, radioactive phenomena, what we know that whenever there is a beta emission, nothing changes in what? Whenever there is a beta emission, nothing changes in mass number. Only atomic number will be increased by 1. Because beta means 1 electron emitted, so proton number will be increased by 1. Clear? So electron emits, so proton number increased by 1. So here x1 will be equal to what? X1 will be equal to new atom. So I am just writing new atom. New atom which have what? Which have A, that mass number will be nothing changed, but atomic number will be Z plus 1. Now again gamma emits. When gamma emits from a nucleus, nothing change. Nothing change. It will not change. Mathematically, no mass number, no atomic number will be changed. So not to worry about that. Means X2 is same as X1. Clear? So next, alpha. If alpha emits, as just before few question I said what? When alpha emits, then mass number will be decreased by 4 and atomic number will be decreased by 2. Mass number will be decreased by 2 and atomic number will be decreased by 2. So what is happening? If mass number is alpha particle emit, then mass number will be decreased by 4. So that x3 will be equal to, right now I am having this new atom. So this new atom, this is the mass number. So A minus 4 and that one will be Z plus 1 minus 2. So this one equal to, new atom. This will be A minus 4. And here it will be plus 1 minus 2 means Z minus 1. So A minus 4, Z minus 1. And last one is that. Who is emitting? And last one is again a beta particle emits. Beta particle emits means nothing change in the mass number. Who will change? The change will be in whom? Change will be in the atomic number. Atomic number will be increased by plus 1. So here it is Z plus 1 minus 1 means minus 1. So if I again increase plus 1, what I will have? So I will have plus 1 means I am having again the same Z. So I am having again the same Z means X4 will be equal to new atom. New atom, here it will be A, rubbing this one, A minus 4, nothing change, and in the atomic number will be Z minus 1 plus 1, so Z will be the answer. So Z, A minus 4 will be X4. So this is the answer. Next one, see, 9-2. is uranium 92-238. यूरेनियम 92-238 फ्रॉम देयर, यूरेनियम 92-238 फ्रॉम देयर, थोरियम 90-234 प्लस अ ब्लैंक स्पेस व्हाट हैज एमिटेड. सो फ्रॉम द इक्वेशन व्हाट आई कैन सी, फ्रॉम द इक्वेशन आई कैन सी दैट एटॉमिक नंबर डिक्रीज बाय 4, मास नंबर डिक्रीज बाय 4, सो ऑब्वियसली अल्फा पार्टिकल, आइदर यू विल राइट अल्फा पार्टिकल और सिंपली राइट Hg42, नो प्रॉब्लम. सो अल्फा पार्टिकल एमिट इन दैट सेकेंड इक्वेशन.